It is a once-in-a-lifetime event. The night sky Wednesday will be both the brightest and darkest ever seen. The full moon will be the second supermoon of the season, and it will appear brighter and larger than usual. And it's called the Flower Blood Moon and will be about 220,000 miles away from Earth tomorrow morning. So let's get to some basics and find out if we'll be able to see it here in Northeast Florida. Joining me on the morning show is Barbara Cohen, a planetary scientist with NASA. Hey, good morning.
Good morning, Bruce.
So let's get to those basics. Why do they call it the Superflower Blood Moon anyway?
Well, tonight we're going to get a really spectacular celestial viewing of the super flower blood moon. It's the flower moon in the springtime. It's a blood moon because we're going to see a lunar eclipse. It's a super moon because it's the closest it's going to get to the Earth in over the whole year. So as it gets closer to the Earth, it's going to look bigger and brighter than a normal full moon. Everyone's going to be able to see that across the U.S. It's going to be some great viewing tonight, so go out and look. For those of us east of the Mississippi, we're not going to see the lunar eclipse. You'll be able to see that if you go to moon.nasa.gov. But those of us west of the Mississippi will see a full lunar eclipse just before sunrise as the sun is coming up at about 4:45. We'll see that total eclipse of the moon.
Yeah, so I hear the best place to actually see this is Hawaii, but we will get a peek here in Florida. And I did some checking. Best time for us, I think, is 4:47, but we're just going to see what they call the penumbral and partial phases. In layman's terms, what's that mean we're going to see?
That's exactly right. So as the Earth gets between the moon and the sun, the Earth will block the sun's light from reaching the moon. That's called the penumbral. That's when you'll see the light start to dim. You'll start to see a little bit of a dimmer moon. You can definitely see that in Florida. The umbral is when the sun is totally blocked from the moon. All of the sun's rays are being refracted through the Earth's atmosphere, like the sunrise or sunset. As the sun rises or sunsets and gets redder, we see that on the Earth. All of those red light that's scattered through the atmosphere gets projected onto the moon. And so in the total eclipse, we see that ghostly coppery color of a full lunar eclipse.
And let's talk a bit about, returning to the moon. I talked with Bill Nelson, the new NASA administrator, just a couple of days ago about the Artemis program and sending U.S. astronauts back. Targets 2024, doable or pushing things in your opinion?
Well, we're working as hard as we can to meet whatever date Congress sets for us. We're definitely on track. We've got a lot of hardware being built, a lot of contracts being let out. I have no doubt Bill Nelson is pushing us as hard as he can to meet that. But whenever we do go back, we're really excited to be putting humans there to do additional field work, bring back additional samples, but to go somewhere we've never been before, to the lunar poles, where we might have resources like a lot of sunlight and possibly even water ice that are going to help us live off the land and help us live and work in space.
Barbara, awesome. Thanks for giving us some perspective about the event tonight and what lies ahead in the future. Good talking to you.